What if you didn't need to kill a chicken to get the meat? Well, you don't. Take a few cells from a chicken, put them in a bioreactor, let them divide and multiply just like they would in a chicken's body, and voila, a chicken nugget. Why do this? Because humans kill a lot of these delicious, flightless birds every year. About 50 billion. And the way these chickens are raised along the way isn't exactly energy efficient or great for the workers. So yeah, cellular-based chicken meat.
It's a concept that I think sometimes is difficult to even grasp. The idea that we don't have to kill another animal to produce real meat.
Though you may have heard of lab-grown or cell-cultured meat for a while, this isn't some theoretical chemistry experiment. The government of Singapore just approved the sale of cell-cultured chicken, and this restaurant is the first place to offer it to diners. But will people be willing to scrap thousands of years of culinary tradition? This is Hard Reset, a series about rebuilding our world from scratch. These are bioreactors, sealed containers that have the perfect conditions inside for microorganisms to be fruitful and multiply. For brewers, the result is beer. For companies like Just, the result is chicken. Specifically, chicken breast meat, since those are the cells they've selected and cultured.
We're not trying to make a whole animal. You're only focusing on growing the edible parts. And instead of growing those parts inside of the animal, you're growing them using a culture process.
This is Vitor. He's one of the scientists at Just who is making this technology a reality. Like serious lab coat and microscope stuff. Science.
But I think that a lot of times people have this connotation that this is still a little bit of Frankenstein, that is synthetic food, when in fact it's not. Understand that we're trying to do exactly what happens in a natural development of an animal. Growing a tissue the same way, but we don't need the animal anymore.
Killing chickens isn't a big deal to most folks, and I get that. It's tasty, juicy meat that you can roast, grill, or fry. You can see why it's the most consumed animal protein in the world. Chickens are as smart as dolphins and smarter than the average 4-year-old human. They're just not cute. So we build entire factories dedicated to killing them. Imagine doing that with kittens or labradoodles. If there's a true alternative, maybe that moral calculus changes. And that may be part of why there's an explosion of venture capital being spent on cell-cultured startups. But none of this money or science really matters unless the chicken tastes like chicken. And as a chicken aficionado, I wanted to sample it. Sadly, it's only been approved in Singapore, a country with a rich history of making delicious chicken.
The form that we're working with is this chicken bite that is breaded and deep fried.
This is Chef Kaimana. He's one of the first cooks to use this product.
The texture is tender and crispy on the outside. It's soft and juicy on the inside.
Basically, it tastes like chicken because it is chicken. Unlike most meat substitutes, which use plants that have been processed to emulate the taste or texture of meat. And let's be honest, they usually just taste like a reminder that you'd rather be eating real meat.
I believe that the plant-based meat industry is helping people to make change in their daily lives. However, I think the advantage of creating good, clean meat is that we don't need to sacrifice the textures that we are accustomed to.
As a kid, my favorite fast food was absolutely McDonald's Chicken McNuggets. So there's a big irony in that now I'm serving the world's most sought after and anticipated chicken nugget in the world.
There's a reason why we don't eat raw chicken these days, because many times it has salmonella, it has a lot of fecal matter that happens during the cross-contamination, during the slaughtering process. So because we are decoupling all of that in this new production system, our product is very sterile. We don't use antibiotics in any stage of production.
Tasty meat, grown sustainably with no weird antibiotics. What's not to love? Well, right now the price. It's expensive for a small portion, but it could be affordable in as soon as 3 to 5 years.
In order to make this happen and to feed the world, you need to produce this in larger tanks, in a higher number of bioreactors. And once that happens, the cost will go down and be at price parity to conventional meat.
And what happens if they truly scale? I mean, picture a scenario. where people only ate cell cultured chicken meat. Don't worry, it wouldn't be all chicken nuggets. You could culture meat from any part of the chicken. Light meat, dark meat, lean, fatty, whatever. 3D printing could give chicken any number of textures, shapes, or even bones. You want a chicken ribeye? You can have it. You'd really just need to get your head around the fact that you're eating lab-grown meat. And you'd have to ditch a product that you've grown accustomed to. Luckily, Chef Kaimana has some experience with that when he was promoting Just's vegetable-based mayonnaise in a place where people have pretty deep brand loyalty to their mayo.
Hawaii is one of those places that you can only use one brand of mayonnaise. I mean, if you stray from that one brand of mayonnaise, your food truck, your restaurant is doomed to failure. It was an uphill battle from day one to really educate people on how making such a simple change in their everyday lives could not only impact their health, but impact the environment, starting with a small switch.
Convincing people to change their brand of mayonnaise might seem silly, but it's a perfect example of how hard it can be to get people to do something they're not used to. And in a world taken over by lab-grown chicken, we would lose the primal satisfaction of being directly connected to our food source. And that might be weird, at least at first. But you know what's really weird? Eating chicken raised in less than awesome factory farms, which yield lots of pollution and require tons of water. Anything is weird, unless it's what you're used to. Maybe we should get used to something that would require less murder and be better for our planet.
I love that food connects us as a human race. This can be a connector. While it might not be available tomorrow or next week or even next year, we have to start somewhere. I think it is the start of something magical.
Come back next time for another episode of Hard Reset. Subscribe to Freethink to watch our other original series and documentaries about technology and people that are changing our world.